哦，不好意思，我想补充一下，因为我觉得刚刚那个问题蛮有趣的。就是其实我，就像李老师刚刚说的，其实修复师不是神吼，我们在培养的过程中，其实都是从历年来的所有经验，还有科学进步研究，一直发展到现在的综合体。所以有时候我们往前看，会觉得说，哎呦，以前的人为什么用这个材料，为什么修成这样？可是因为当时的发展就是到那里，而且可能当时的观念就觉得这样已经是最棒的处理方式，所以其实我们自己在讨论修复是很某方面是很保守的事情，因为我们都是很短暂的拥有者，这些艺术品都会活得比我们更长，所以其实如果我们现在把它当成自己的创作品，加入非常多最新最棒，然后觉得一用一劳永逸，其实某方面来说是。风险蛮大，蛮危险的。对，所以我们现在比较讲求就是可逆性啊。我们现在做到这里，那未来的人如果有更好材料，觉得我们已经退流行了，这东西已经很老旧，那就把它拿掉，再换新的，继续往下走这样子。那这个艺术品保持它的原貌，真实的部分尽量维持着。那之后修饰的部分就是延长它的寿命和大家去欣赏的价值这样子。那我觉得现在我们国内每个团队呢，基本上我们在学习的历程都有一定对物质的了解程度。我说物质就是如何保存它、保护它，还有用的材料，这些是有一个比较普遍性的原则，所以基本上不会落差非常大。但当然有一些修复师可能会有一些独门绝技或是一些配方，这个我们不是很清楚。但是以我们来讲，我们用的材料就是常常跟国际间交流，然后通用测试确认过比较稳定的材质，才会用在修复作品上面。这样子，好，谢谢。
那有没有对器物部分有问题的？而且其实我们在下面哈的展览，其实现场那边它就有一些器物修复的现场在那哈在那边展示。那如果有兴趣的话，可以去那边看看。哎，这位先生有。
对于器物部分，我想提出一个问题，因为现在多媒体的创作很多，有没有遇过要修复录像作品的经验？
请问你说的录像作品是像设备吗？
比如说像白南准的摄影、录影、影像作品，比如说它是一段影片。然后作为一个作品，因为现在现当代艺术，就当然前面讨论的可能是时间轴往回推的部分，但当艺术在发展的时候，接下来我相信，往后再看个10年，一定还会有更多我们现在没有想象过的所谓称之作艺术的部分的媒材出现，然后比如说像录影、声音，然后档案画面，甚至现在有录像作品的销售，它是直接录在一支 USB 里面，然后就卖给藏家。那藏家获得的作品就是那一支 USB 跟里面的档案。那你们有没有遇过这种数位媒材的作品修复过的经验？
目前的话是还没有接触到数位媒材的部分，可是你刚才讲的那一种，现在当代复合媒材的确对我们来讲是让我们非常头痛的，因为你像早期的一些作品，它可能都是很单纯哦，青铜、黄铜或是铸铁，非常单纯的单一的材质，那我们很容易就是可以就它的材质去做相对应的修复的方式。可是，一直到现在近代，它可能一件作品里面，它就混合了不同的材质。那这个时候，因为像木头跟金属这两种是属性很不一样，一个可能是像木头，它对一些材料或是对温湿度环境它比较敏感，那金属它可能就没有像木头这么敏感。那这个时候我们就要去考虑到说，我是要在这两个材质中间去折中。那现在又有更多，它可能又加入玻璃、塑胶，或是更多其他的。那通常我们遇到这种媒材合在一起在做的时候，我们是没有办法就说 可能一两天我就决定说，好，这个东西我就怎么做。通常这个东西如果送来之后，我们是必须要跟可能收藏家或者是就是必须要跟收藏家花很长一段时间去沟通，说你这个东西我可能只有可能帮你处理到什么样的程度，这样子我们没就是没有办法像其他的材质，就是跟你非常的保证说我可以帮你做到百分之百的，你就是可以放个五年十年之后都不会有什么问题，因为现在的复合媒材它多变因子太多了，所以我们就没有办法保证那么多。
The video art and it was with that they are like kinetic. There is like a lot of problems actually. You know, especially with consolidation of video art, there is like an obsolescence that there was like in 15 years, 20 years probably, if you don't change the way of the video, they are not going to be reproduced. And the same happened with the kinetic art. You know, the pieces that they have movement and sounds, you need to keep them how the original is. So many times when we have been restoring it, it's very difficult to restore the motors because you need to keep the same speed. So because if you change the speed, how you see the perception of the movement will be different. For example, last week we had been checking a kinetic artwork that is from a Japanese artist that has a motor and need to pop up the air to three balloons, but one of them is not working. So it's not a work that you can exhibit. It's like it's broken. So how you approach to this kind of work is totally different, and you need to take into account other concepts.
I know nothing about video, but what I know is that the Getty Institute decided to do conservation on videos, and there are other institutes, they say, well, we just digitize it, and then there's no problem anymore with the video, because the video is actually only a transfer. But suppose you have an original tape from Nang Yung Pang, you know. There you go.
There are also concept problems if you change from analog to digital, if it's the same grain, it's the same
Absolutely.
Monitor. So there is like all the kind of concept and problems. The Tate Museum is working for a long time with Tate Media works. And they are doing really a very good job. So if you are interested, you could just check the webpage of Tate Modern.
Yeah, but there is no consensus all over. You understand?
Consensus?
Yeah, consensus on how you should.
There is conservation standards for how to work.
For a video?
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
For sure, and for the kinetic work too. For example,
for kinetics.
In July, it was a conservation of kinetic artwork in Milano, and it was really very interesting. Uh-huh. It was like conference only
it
relative
icon,
with
yeah.
the
yeah, yeah.
conservation of kinetic works.
Yeah, so, but for video,
and for video, is there is almost the same problems, especially with the obsolescence. So you need to change. You need to readapt.
Because
when the companies stop doing the monitors, and when they change to another kind of system, mm-hmm. it's almost done. And Nan Chun Peck is a very well case.
But that is actually a very interesting thought, because, Philips stopped making videos, but it is also very difficult to get the same smalton, you know, which is a blue pigment from the Renaissance. So they also stopped making pigments to some extent. So when you compare these two,
yeah, it's a,
it's another yeah. dilemma.
Yeah, for sure. So yeah. And also happens the same with the light, because some of the works they are using a special light bulbs, yeah. and they have also a lifespan. So when you need to change, you need to also look for the same kind of wave. You have to match the artist's work, because it could be when you see it, the perception will be almost different.
Yeah.
So you need to keep, and when the companies they don't do it anymore, is when the problems arise.
Yeah. Yeah, it's a hard job for conservators of modern art. When you look at Tingley, you know, all the
Tingley, yeah, for sure.
Everything is
yeah.
is moving and
now they
a
are
lot of
doing,
damage.
Yeah, in Amsterdam, mm-hmm. and very a very good exhibition actually.
Yeah.
Yeah, I would love to go. Yeah, for sure.
Yeah. A lot of noise.
Okay, 那最后一个问题。
大家好。这其实不是问题啊，今天其实我是代表主办单位，要谢谢在座每一个，包含台上跟来宇的与会的贵宾哦，因为艺术鉴定这个主题哦，是我们论坛今年有史以来办最难办的一场。就我们这个主题生出来之后，找不到人可以说，尤其在国内，原因是因为像就鉴定这一方面领域的，目前国内专家应该就是在修复方面。那修复方面，其实台湾有很多修复的人才，不管是从俄罗斯学习、西班牙学习，或者是日本学习，都有不同的方面。那但是他们愿意站出来，然后愿意分享自己的经验，这个部分是非常非常不容易。那同时，今天各位也都感受到，就是其实修复的技术方面还有观念是需要沟通的。所以其实像我们的经验跟这些专家在合作的经验当中也是。共识是需要达到一个共识，它是需要过程，所以它并没有一个谁就能够做出最好的 best practice 这样子的一个方案，而是它是达到一个共识。所以我们希望也是借由这一次这样的一个主题，是开启国内就是达到共识的一个阶段，因为它其实我们面临到的困难就是它很像潘多拉的盒子，你一打开之后，你不知道你面对的是什么，那你不说也不行，因为每个人都有可能会要收藏嘛，那所以这部分的话，我是主办单位是非常谢谢正修哈、哦，愿意参与这一场论坛，然后给我们各个面向，不管是器物、纸质各个媒材方面的一些建议、哦、那也希望就是各位之后也可以后续跟我们一起关注这样的议题，然后让台湾艺术鉴定这方面的领域可以更健全。那也谢谢 AIA 来这边参与我们的论坛，谢谢。
好，那我们这一场的时间就到这边为止。好，谢谢各位。
让我们谢谢掌声，就是感谢五位贵宾。